think this is around by the time where they would tell you listen to this track, bitch.
I don't give a fuck now, like me.
You so concerned about my real life, and that's alright, but who are you? Just another nigga with a strap. It don't take rocket science to shoot. You don't know shit about getting bricks out, you probably still work true for true. You don't know shit about on your blood, cause you paid your bills with all that loot. How about your baby about to be born and he don't got Pampers wipes or food? How about your mama fucking your best friend and y'all both just finished school? But it's okay, she thinks it's cool, you're in her way, it's time you move. And you just paid all her damn bills, so you feel like a fool. So what do you suggest I do? You think you know? You got no clue, so please don't tell me what you think. I ain't been
through. I don't give a fuck if they don't like me. I say I don't give a fuck if they don't like me. Oh no, I don't give a fuck if they don't like me. Sorry, I don't give a fuck if they don't like me.
Welcome to AJ's Team. Yes, I'm back. I've been away for a week. Finally graduated. Achievement ring. I am on my way to law school now. So, it's amazing how as soon as I got on here, I have Trump and his whole cabinet need to be impeached. And the first thing I saw when I looked over on my right-hand side, I am on Periscope as well, the person said, what Trump have done to me? And I'm like, what have Trump did anything for you? Trump have not did anything for United States, and I'm all about United States. See, I care about United States just as my ancestors care about the United States, because we built this country. And when someone who asked that question, that makes me think that you know nothing about politics. And it clearly shows when you ask that question that you don't know anything about politics. As we can see today, Trump is trying to cover up, and now he's so damn bold with it. He's having a session with Russia, coming over here. A Russian ambassador could come over here and talk. Now, come on, I've been calling this out, that this man is a mantran, and you guys are still on board with this man. What do he have to do? Clearly, I guess he can't go into Times Square and kill someone. And you uneducated people will not. And I understand why he said, I love my uneducated people. The reason why he says that is because you do not know anything about the Constitution. You do not know about Congress. You do not know about the Senate. That's why he said he loves his uneducated people. Because most of your information, unfortunate, Bill O'Reilly is on podcast. He has not gone away. So, he's no longer on the news media. But you are getting your information from Bill O'Reilly. You're getting your information from Henley. And they are more uneducated than you are. You know nothing about what's going on, so of course you're going to say, oh yeah, he's doing a great job. How is he doing? He haven't passed a law yet, people. Not one law. He haven't passed one law yet. In these 6 months, trust me, if you go back on President Obama, he have passed so many laws at this time. So the person who asked that question, what did Trump do to me? He has done a hell of a lot. Not only to me, to Americans who love this country. I love this country. He failed to realize about diversity. He think that he is the one in charge. We don't need China. We don't need anybody. And that's, honey, I just mentioned that. So don't come up here, because if you come at me, you better have your history. You better have everything, what is going on. Don't come at me on my show. I'm telling you. Because I will whoop your ass and turn you around and spit you out. You understand me? Know your history. Don't come at me. I'm being nice now. Because I just mentioned that he put an executive order. Let me do it in baby terms. He have not passed nothing because he did not give them nothing to pass. So, you're underneath me. No, not going there. I'm not trying to belittle you. I really am not. But if you come on my show, you're going to get belittled if you start. So, especially if you don't know what you're talking about. I don't need to ask you anything. This is my show, not yours. So, anybody who knows and who's not an uneducated person who followed Trump, because he's still in his percentage is like 30% people still rooting on. So, then something is wrong with the other people who's not saying Trump is the best president. Something is wrong with it, right? No, of course not. Nothing is wrong with the people who is not voting for this idiot or who's not saying that this idiot is all right. That's over half of what you know. Like, it's 63% people. 63% of people are not saying that he is a great president. So something is wrong. No, he have not. He have put out executive order, but we're not even going to talk about executive order because we know it have not passed. One thing that did pass in legislation was that dumbass bill that is not, it didn't pass, it's not going to pass in the Senate. And it's a shame that y'all guys so have so much a hatred towards somebody of skin color that you're going to vote against yourself like it's not going to affect you. How the hell Donald Trump going to know anything about you guys? He know nothing about you. He only know who have money. He never lived this life. He only lived privileged life. He only lived a privileged life. Come on, people. Wait, when you gonna wake up? You think he's for you? No, he's not, because he's a white man. He doesn't give a damn about you. This is what you call reconstruction. Now, explain to you about reconstruction. It only happened one time when Lincoln set the slaves free. And I know y'all don't know about Reconstruction. I'm not saying all, but this person on here don't. Now it's doing the Reconstruction. Everything what President Obama have done, he's trying to erase the history of President Obama. They failed to realize President Obama did not just set out and help African Americans. He set out and helped people who are in United States are Americans. Y'all talk about deporting, building a wall. If you go in your history, President Obama was the president out of all presidents have deported more people in history. Trump haven't did that yet. But you continue to disregard what President Obama have done for this country. He also have worked hard to give poor people, we are, most of us are a paycheck away of being poor. He have helped poor people with ACA that y'all didn't even know Obamacare was ACA. Most of the poor people who voted for Trump didn't even know Obamacare was ACA. And it's helping them. This man have been in the news about Russia more than any president. Y'all remember Watergate, Nixon. Now let's go back there. Nixon also fired his FBI agent. 2 weeks later, he was impeached. Now they're thinking, oh, there's a problem because he fired Comey. And he really tried to influence Comey not to investigate Flynn. He tried to pull his rank on Comey. And everybody know Comey is the one that keep up all his records. And they just presented this, that Comey said, President Trump, I never say President Trump, but that's what they said. He's not my president. He said President Trump called him and tried to influence him not to do an investigation. So basically, I wouldn't be surprised if Flint wind up dead somewhere because he had more information than anything. Because he tried to stop Comey for investigating Flint. Flynn have something going on. Flynn know more than what he's saying he does. So, if Flynn wind up dead somewhere, I'm not going to be surprised, people. That guy know more than what he's leaning on. So, Comey told him, yeah, he is a great guy. Because Trump said, yeah, Flynn is such a good guy, he doesn't need to be investigated. You don't investigate on him. And what did Comey say? Yes, he's such a great guy. Now, on the other hand, he also admitted on national television, Trump did, said the reason why he fired Comey is because he was investigated. He told him he wasn't going to investigate him anymore. People, you got to do something. On 2018 is coming. Because these GOP, the grand old party, the Republicans, are allowing this man to stay in. He just... Let me calm down. Because you guys really don't know what's going on. And some of you guys do know what's going on. And you can overlook that because you want this white Caucasian male to do. You want it to go back. You're not getting slaves anymore, people. You're not getting slaves anymore. You're going to do your own thing. Now I'm going to my people. I want to talk to you guys. I'm hoping you guys listening. Let's take our money. We spend $2.6 trillion out of all the race. We need to get our money and don't use our money on white establishments. We need to start supporting our own African Americans establishment. That's why I transfer my money in One United. You can easily do it. Get on the internet, have some money in another bank, and transfer your money. You can open up a savings account, people. Let's start doing that. Showing them they don't need us. We don't need you. It's a lot of black businesses out here that you can support as going to, and also that bank can support them. Let's take our money away and let them feel the heat and see who spends the most money. We have to unite, my people. I could care less about any other race right now. I can only think about my race. Because we spend a lot of money. And we're the one that are being targeted by cops. We're the one who are being targeted by white nationalists. We're the one who are being targeted by Session, who's supposed to be the DOJ leader. We're the one who's being targeted by Trump. We're the one who's being targeted by Banner. We are the one, because of the color of our skin, we're being targeted. People can sit up there all day and say it's no racism. You see it. You don't want to see it. It's because you have that white privilege. They're not. And when I say my people, I'm not talking about African Americans. I am talking about Asians. And some of you Asians, you're Caucasian. You're not. You're still dark skinned. I'm talking about my Hispanic brothers and sisters. We need to unite with them. We need to come together. We need to stop saying their nationality is this. Their nationality is that. Their nationality is everything. Their nationality have Africa in it. They are Africans. We need to unite. And that is the way they are so afraid of us uniting. That's the reason why they separate us. Not on only by just name. They separate us on how the income is. They separate us on everything. Economics. We need to unite together. Because they're going to keep this right here, what they have. They have hatred and fear. Hatred and fear. They are so afraid that we will unite that they will find out they are the minorities. We are not the minorities, but we are a minority because we separate ourselves from them. We separate, when I say them, our brothers and sisters. This man is a matron, and they are still standing up for this man, knowing that he is part, and I know you might be don't know what a matron is. It is a person who was bought by a foreign country, and who's going to do for that foreign person. We never had this before. This guy is not, he's informing our enemy. He released important and confidential information. Not to our allied, to our enemies. But people are continuing to stick up for this guy. He still has 37% backing him up. This is why I am calling for unity. We have to have unity. They have put propaganda all through news. And it's crazy because I was watching something. How they put propaganda. People are still watching this news because they want to feel comfortable. They want to be superior. They want to have that I am the majority attitude. They want to keep their white privileges. They are afraid how they treat us. They think we're going to treat them. We're not that nasty. We're not that evil. We're not afraid. We don't have that hatred in us. This is why I need you guys to also look up a book. This is not my book. I never wrote this book, but I read this book. and it'll deprogram you. It called four agreements. We start this at an early age of being programmed. Four, F-O-U-R, agreements. You got to pick that book up. Read it. I guarantee you won't put it down. I couldn't stop reading that book. I started that book at, I say, 10 o'clock in the morning, and I did not finish that book until, I think it was 6 o'clock p.m. that same day. Go and read that book. Go and read that book. I am talking to people on, because I have a podcast that I'm talking to. I have a lot of people following me. I am also, I have a lot of my recordings that goes to my Twitter that people follows me. So, sir, please. Anyway, it's amazing how Caucasians come on to my show and have a lot and don't have a lot to say. Have negative, and they have did this through, and that's four agreements. Oh, yes. Four agreements is that this is for dealing with people like what I have on my Periscope. Four agreements, and I want to say this one thing, what four agreements have. Four agreements have, do not allow someone to fertilize your mind when they say something negative. And I do not allow anyone to fertilize my mind with that bullcrap. But on the grid, please go and get that book. And it's another book I read the same day. and it was a longer book. It's like 400 pages. And it's from an African-American male. And it was an awesome book as well. And it calls Just Mercy. Just Mercy. Now, I want to also quote something that was in Just Mercy. He was talking about, and I can't give it away. I want your guys to read it. He was saying that most people who, and you'll understand when you read this book, most people who do death sentence and electrocute someone who have a mental challenge or have mental problems are the people who don't want to see that they are broken, because the people who have a mental problem are showing they are broken. It's a great book. It's a true story about the guy. Let me get his name up. Matter of fact, I can get it on my thing here. I just remember the book name. It is awesome, but I want to also give him a shout out, who actually wrote this book, and it's Brian Stevenson. It is a great book, people. Please go and read it. It is based on a true story of his life when he became an attorney. And you know, I'm all for that. And I thought it was, I just read it. Someone introduced this book to me and I read it because they know that I'm going to be an attorney. And I just want people to read that book. Read Four Agreements and Just Mercy, A Story of Justice and Redemption, from Brian Stevenson. Great book, people. Great book. But you guys who are actually backing up Trump, agreeing what Trump is doing, it's sad, because you're going to run down the country. You're going to run down the country. You're going to destroy this country. This country right now is vulnerable because you voted someone in. Now you're sitting up there saying, No. I regret voting for her. It's too late. We still have to deal with this guy for four. It feels like he's been in office for like 6 years. And he hasn't. He's only been in office for almost six months. And it feels like freaking 6 years. Oh my God. It's like this guy have not did anything for the country. Nothing. That is the craziest, saddest thing in life. That this guy, all he does is do executive order and going after people of color. People of color. He have not did anything for no one. All he's trying, everything he tries to do is something what President Obama have done. Reconstruction. And you guys are just supporting him. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. But when a bomb drop on your ass, because he's going to be safe. When a bomb drop on your ass, then you're going to say, oh, yes. No, you're going to be dead. You're going to be dead. His whole cabinet need to be impeached. His whole cabinet. We could go down to the vice president. He never did a damn thing for Indiana. It's an insult for him to even just come up. Because he was rich, they went on and got him. Go back in his history and see what he did. He's a fucking hypocrite. He loved talking about religion this and religion that. Listen, he hate gays so much. And I tell anybody, because I'm gay, I'm a lesbian. He hate gays so much. And I'm like, why you guys, and it's not on him, why Pence and all you guys worry about what somebody do in the closed door? It have nothing to do with you. Not at all. It have nothing to do with you. But you want somebody to be like you? You want to tell people what to do? And most Caucasians are well known for that. Try to tell people what to do, how to do it, and when to do it. They've been like that for a century of time. Just like O'Reilly tried to tell Ludacris what to do. You should respect women. And look at him. He dog women out. Sexual harass these women all day long. Paying a woman $9 million to keep it hush hush. All day. That is crazy. But they say, do as I say, not as I do. Caucasian always well known for that. But I'm not going to leave out my people. Y'all people are very judgmental. My people will judge. And I always ask this question about my people. Is it because you've been judged by the color of your skin all your life? That's why you judge so much? Is it? I think that is what's the problem. Because my people would judge a person like me. The first thing I hear a guy says, and it's crazy, because they act like I don't have a mind. So I live with my uterus. All you need is a good boom, 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 boom. That do not make someone gay. Not at all. That do not make someone gay at all. So you can't change someone if someone do not want to change themselves. But I had to go on my people too. I just couldn't leave them out as well. But Pence, I really think Pence is gay, but hey, you could go ahead and spread that to them. They need to look at this anyway, because I'm talking about all of them. They need to get rid of her. DeVos, you should have been booed. You should have been booed at your HCBU. See, you don't even know how to say HBCU. You don't know nothing about us. You said that we volunteered to make our own colleges. No, we didn't. The Ivy League colleges did not want us to be in their school. They're still doing it today. Because we can look at Alabama. You go down to Alabama. These white folks told the judge that they didn't want African Americans in their school. And they wanted to be segregated. Guess what? The judge gave it to them. Gave it to them. They have separate school. Desegregation is alive and kicking. Racism is alive and kicking. See, you guys don't know about that. It's because you don't live it. You don't live it. live and kicking. Alabama, look it up. Alabama. And she had the nurse to go into HBCU and think you're going to talk and you're taking funds away from the HBCU. Why? Because this president up in the United States, the White House, want to weaponize the country. How did that get you anywhere? Of weaponizing and taking away from people? Destroying people's lives? Did that? Guess so. Then we get Milton. He's in there. He's a well-known person to deal with Russia. Who else? We have Bannon. He finally got rid of Bannon from being that high-top person. He didn't even... Y'all know y'all president don't read. Y'all know y'all president don't read. You know where he get his information from? The propaganda news. He doesn't do any research. He does not even do daily briefs. Y'all know that? But he can get on Twitter all day long and talk that mess. And what he said lately, he said, I can invite Russia. I can meet with Russia people. It is my prerogative. He didn't say prerogative, but you know what I'm talking about. I can do that. I'm the president. Last time I checked, Russia and United States been enemies for years. This is just not the beginning. Go back in your history. They have never been allies. They have never been allies. Never. Never been allies at all. Of course, most Caucasians want me to shut up. They do. They want me to shut up because they don't want me to tell the truth. People need to learn about the history, and then you come up with and you'll see, oh, they same tactics have never changed. They same tactics will never change. I'm not saying all Caucasian, but most of you are the most ignorant. And you know what ignorant means? Lack of knowledge. Most of them are. We can talk about Richard Spencer. If y'all know about Richard Spencer, he's one of the white nationalists going out of here and say, we're not going anywhere. Boy, you didn't even know your history. Roland Martin had to whoop that ass on national TV because you didn't know about your history. They are in Louisiana trying to defend statues in Louisiana that they tearing down regardless. And you keep on saying heritage. You still calling us black and our heritage is African. How is a rebel flag, and I would be embarrassed, totally embarrassed to represent that flag, because you lost the war and it have nothing to do with heritage. It have nothing to do with that. It have a whole lot to do with that. Let me go back. General Lee told y'all ass to put that up. And they did put it up until the civil rights came along. And then they decided to bring the flag down. Now, that have nothing to do with hatred anymore. Then when they brought that flag up, that had something to do with hatred. Please do your history, Lord. I'm not trying to be like my ancestors. I already wrote my poem and I already said what I had to say. I am not going to be my ancestor teaching your ass nothing. Stop being ignorant. Stop learning about something. It just makes no sense. It does not make no sense. At all. And someone on here asked me, when did the Civil War end it? Who is at talk? When did the Civil War started? Chris Attock. Who is that? Waiting. waiting. This is my show, not yours. Now answer that. You asked me, when did it start? Who is Chris Attuck? I have an idiot on here really want to challenge me right now. And I usually don't respond because I haven't responded to the idiot for the longest. But don't look it up. Tell me. Tell me and I'll tell you when it's done. Actually, I'm going to tell you something. A civil war is blooming right now. You failed to realize that. This civil war have never stopped. This is what in history time you will say the civil war have stopped. Civil war haven't stopped. Because we are still going at you, stupid fools. You white nationalists. Been going on for years. When did the Ku Klux Klan stop putting crosses in front of people? Young people. Just doing. When did the hatred stop? Have not stopped. It's still going on. And civil war is blowing up now. And I'm going to be right in it. So, who is Chris Attuck? Can't answer that, can you? I'm not going to school you. Go and look up your history. I told you, don't challenge me on my show. This is not your show. You don't ask questions, I do. And then I'll answer your question. I hate when I have to school people, but in a way I do love it. Because I know they don't know it. You can look it up now on the computer. See who that is. Yeah. Then you'll find out why it started. But anyway, I tell you, and we as African American, please, I beg of you, let's unite because, excuse me, I'm laughing because I have to keep dealing with these little idiots. I don't know why I have idiots coming at me that don't know history. I can ask them right now. When did Lincoln sign the Emancipation? Come on. When did Lincoln sign the Emancipation? I can say that off my head. When? 1868. When did it take effect? When did it take effect? You might be have a computer up there. Stop taking so long. It took effect 1865. When did it take? It never did. 1865, actually, when the emancipation was already taken care of. Look it up, baby. 1865. The problem is, I'm going to ask you this question. How could you emancipate anyone who was already free? He's on the amendments. I ask you a question. I want you to talk to me. I am on Periscope and I'm talking to someone who want to challenge me. So I'll go that route with them for a minute. I'm not going to answer your question, fool. You have not answered not one of my questions, what I asked. When did, are you going to answer my question? How can you emancipate anyone who was already free? Okay. Anyway, he's not going to answer it. I'm not going to waste my time. So, I think they need to get their own show. But anyway, people, I just love, I already said, the two books that I recommend that you guys need to read. And I really want to talk about, I love when Caucasians sit up there and they talk about, because Bill O'Reilly said this, it came out that he's supposed to know so much about African Americans. I don't get it. I would love a Caucasian to explain to me, how can you know so much about African American when you have white privileges? I just can't understand that. You cannot understand people when you already have privileges. When you are born, you don't have to sit down with your kids and tell them, when the police pull you over, you're supposed to sit in the car with your hands out. When a police tell you to lay down on the ground, you're supposed to hold your hands up and lay down. But that still don't work anymore as well, because we know a young man in Florida held his hand up. He was a nurse dealing with a mental challenged young man. He laid down and got shot anyway. I was watching, doing a research on, when I was watching a video and this young man was jogging. He was just jogging. African-American. He saw this cop pulled over. He said, put your hands up. He turned on his phone. People, you have the right to videotape. They tried to pass that law that cops you can't videotape a cop. That is a lie. Trust me. Look it up. This is the main reason why I'm going into civil rights law litigations. It's because of these attitudes. And most of my people do not know the law. And I want to help my people. I have an LLC. It calls the Rebirth and the New Trend. I have that. I help my people. Sometimes I go out and I speak. I am always looking for people who want to join, who want to fight this cause. Because I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to fight you. I'm not going to explain nothing to you. I'm not going to educate you. And you are not going to ask me any damn questions. Because you did that with my ancestors. You're going to answer my questions. People, we have a bill right now, started in the 60s, that is sitting there. And they have never passed. And that's the civil rights bill. It have never passed. Why? Because we tend to saying we are content with what these Caucasians offer us. You know what they offer us? You want to know what they offer us? Not all Caucasian. I have to mention this. I am not talking about all. I am talking about these conscious and these unconscious Caucasians who are racist. You understand? And when I say unconscious, some of them don't even know that they are racist. Some of them will sit up there and say a black joke and sit up there and say, oh, but I'm not racist. I have a black friend. When they have to turn away and say they have a black friend, they are racist. So, we have a civil rights bill been sitting on in the legislation. They just threw that aside. It's because they are not going to pass it. Nobody tried to fight for it. We get so content. Oh, they're going to give us something. You know what they're giving us? Chitlins with shit in it. They are not giving us nothing. And the first thing they say, y'all blacks always asking for something. Well, bitch, we didn't even ask you to go over there and get our ancestors, who, by the way, was free. You went over there and got our ancestors. Why? Because the Asian people failed to do your plow your fields. The Irish failed to plow your fields. So we had to go and get some strong people and African people so you can rape. Yeah, we have to go and get them. So let's go over there to Africa and go and get these people. They strong and husky. They could build because we already had cities. Until our people realize that we are kings and we are queens, we will never go nowhere. Until we start getting in our head that we need to unite with other people of color, we will never get anywhere. When you see a brother or you see a sister having a disagreement, go over and say, brother, my king, go over there and say, my sister, my queen, it's better things we need to fight for than this. Let's break it up. Let's get it together. Let's come together. We need to unite. And I just said that not too long ago. We need to come together. They want to sit up there and say, yeah, Lincoln set you free. You should love us now. Kumbaya. Let's come together. Let's come together and love one another. No. You didn't do that for us. Because real hanging started after the emancipation. Remember, they wouldn't hang nobody when they were owned. Because if they hang a slave, they owe the slave master. It started occurring after Lincoln set the so-called slaves free, that we was free and we had cities. That's why they keep on trying to figure out about the pyramids. So they couldn't figure out the pyramids. So what did they do? They start saying, oh, white people was Cleopatra. Oh, yeah, Cleopatra wasn't black. Nah, white people were. It was all white folks over there. But then you have to sit back and say, it is hot as hell over there in Africa. Why their skin stayed light? Critical thinking. That's what you need to do. Critical thinking. Broadcast. You do need to broadcast. You need to start talking what's on your mind. But be educated first. Know your history. Because a lot of us don't know our history. The only reason why I know history, because I love history. But we have to know. Stop being in our head and thinking that we are still slaves. Stop acting like a slave. You still trying to fight master. Fuck master. Let's try to fight with us together. Let's unite. That's what we need to do. And then we can fight master. Not by physical form. By intelligence and taking their laws away from them. You can use their own laws against them. You can use their own laws against them. Just think about it. Put it in your head. Think about it. What you want to do? I had a young lady who kept on calling. She's 23 years old. And I was trying to be a mentor. I was really trying to really mentor her. And she didn't know what she should do. And she said she liked eating. She don't like cooking. And she liked traveling. So I basically told her, go ahead, apply for one of the airlines and be a stewardess. She traveled and she could eat. Something like that. But I no longer talk to her because I can only deal with immaturity. I don't have patience for it. But I think I stirred her along the way so she can do the right thing. Whatever. So, I want you guys to understand. that don't let Caucasians put anything in your head. You don't have to answer them. Because I think our ancestors answered them enough. They mean nothing to us right now. We need to start worrying about ourselves. We need to start uniting right up to ourselves. It is always going to be a mind game. You know what I'm saying? It's a mind control. They want you to answer them because they want to control you. I am not that person. You will not control me. I will not answer you. I will not call you sir. I will not call you none of that, because I am not my fucking ancestors. I could care less what you think of me. That I really do. You would know me. If you watch my show, I could care less. You want to control somebody, you need to go and find some house Negro woman or house Negro of a man. I am not that person. If you think that you could control me, that's not going to help either. So, at the end of the day, I am not that person you think you're going to control. This is the reason why you have not got any answers from me, because I'm not going to answer. I'm not that yes ma'am or yes sir. Not that type of person. I know every date that you just put up there, I know it. So, I'm not going to sit up there just like your ancestors called my ancestors niggers. I'm not an uneducated niggers. You love for me to... You want me to prove something to you. I'm not going to prove something to you, because I know what I have up here. Until you learn how to recognize your ignorance, until you learn how to recognize that you're a racist, until all this, then wrong person to come at, for real. Wrong person to come at, because I am a civil right. I am going to school. Law school, a civil rights litigation, civil rights, everything. I'm all for that. So at the end of the day, if you don't see my dashiki, you don't see my line of Judith on here, everything means something to me. This is right here is from Ethiopia, of my family and my tribe, that they use, they make their lips a little bigger. So when you come at me, get your life together. I will not answer your question. Simple as that. I have no respect for your people. What your people have done, and I'm not talking about all Caucasian, I'm talking about most of you. What your people have done to my family and my ancestors, you have the galls to ask me questions. You can get your fucking white ass out of here. You're going to be blocked anyway. Mind control. People, stop being under mind control. Take your life back, my people. Take your life back. You do not have to answer anything what these Caucasians ask of you. And I don't like using white, so I use about 3 or 4 times. Don't let them, don't call them white. They're not pure. They're not innocent. A lot of it coming out now in the news, the right news. You have to search for it. It is showing that they are liars. When the man shot Walter Scott in the back, then he said that Walter Scott grabbed his taser in his gun. That was a lie. Because of videotapes, they are showing you they are liars, they are thieves, and they are rapists. You have a good day. Mind control. Can clear it up.
Mind control, corruption of your attention.